Good evening to you. Sunny and 79 degrees right now with a light northwest wind and dry air in place. The dew points in the upper 40s right now. We'll hold on to that dry air through the night. And temperatures already starting to fall back. Our weather watchers reported highs of 80 degrees from Arthur Hetzke at Barnes, 76 today at Seneca from Eldon Tenike, and 78 for the high from the Fosters at Eskridge. It's now 79 in Topeka, 78 at Emporia, and several lower 80s over the western counties. The overall trend for the next several hours will be a gradual drop in temperatures under a generally clear sky as the clear conditions have prevailed throughout the afternoon. Had clouds this morning. I doubt we'll see nearly that amount by tomorrow morning, but we are tracking the next round of clouds and showers. This Pacific moisture that's coming in, crossing the now northern Gulf of California, arriving into Arizona. This Pacific moisture, remnants from what was once Hurricane Simon, falling apart. That'll be coming our way. Thin clouds may arrive late tonight or tomorrow morning. You'll see this on Future Track, a few thin clouds here and there tomorrow morning around 7:30. Increasing partly cloudy skies through the day. A few showers and storms will develop, mainly the eastern half of the area during the night tomorrow night. And then as we head into Thursday, watch as initially this model has just scattered showers. But by late afternoon and evening, the rain fills in. And late Thursday through Thursday night, the most widespread rain, this is now up to Friday morning at 6:30 as the rain starts to push off to the southeast. So Thursday into Thursday night should be the heaviest of the rain. All of this, when you add it all together, could fall a total of 1 to 2 inches of rain, especially over the southern counties, starting up a little bit tomorrow night through Thursday and Thursday night as well. So a pretty good soaking of rain area-wide with this system. But just ahead of that, before the clouds get here, tomorrow morning, 4:15, you'll start to see a shadow cast across the moon before the totality of a lunar eclipse turns into that blood red kind of coloring of it, called the blood moon sometimes. And then that wraps up right as the sun rises tomorrow morning. A little bit more information on that at KansasFirstNews.com on my blog. Head to weather, click on Matt's blog, and look for the story. It's called Lunar Eclipse Viewing. So you want to check that out. I'll give you some more specifics on the timing of seeing that early tomorrow morning. Then the cloud cover starts rolling our way. Scattered showers and storms late Wednesday night. Thursday into Thursday night, the best rain chance, followed by a few more showers Friday. And cooler weather, 61 Friday, 59 for the high by Saturday as some cool weather settles in. As we look at the sunset at Carbondale yesterday from Larry and Linda Berlew, the beautiful sunrise this morning at Overbrook from Gary Hoffsummer, and east of Emporia from Lucy Fink. Shouldn't have that much cloud cover tomorrow morning. That does make the lunar eclipse visible, but by late tomorrow night, the rain chances return.
So if you want to see that eclipse, set your alarm for what, 4 in the morning?
4:15 would be a good time to start seeing it.
All right. Thanks, Matt.